Welcome back. It's been a question time session with the Chairman, Revenue Mobilization, Allocation and Fiscal Commission, Engineer Elias Mbam. He will be telling us more about how the Federation account is being managed.
One of the indices you raised in considering what is due to public officers at different levels is the foreign reserve. So what is the current state of Nigeria's foreign reserve?
It's falling. It has fallen. I think it's 20 something. I don't have the actual figure, but it's about 20 something now. And once the commission finishes this process, it sends its proposed or its determined remuneration, the remuneration appropriate for executive and judiciary to the National Assembly for legislative works. But that of the states, there's the governor and all the members of the executive at the state level and at the local government level are sent to the State House Assembly for legislation. But whatever has been determined by the commission as what is appropriate for members of the legislature is final. It doesn't go through any legislative process.
I think we'll need to carry Nigerians along as much as possible, because sometimes when such term is mentioned, a lot of people are disconnected. What actually is the foreign reserve about?
It is when you produce, you sell and get. If what you import is more than what you generate, you will have a depletion foreign reserve. But if it's the other way around, your foreign reserve will grow. It's an indicator of how heady your economy is.
Is this different from the excess crude account?
Excess crude account is an account established by the federal government where we have a benchmark for price of oil, crude oil and gas. And any time you have crude oil sold above that benchmark, that difference is put into that account, and that's what they call excess crude account.
But do you have?
It has no difference. There's no relationship directly with what you call external reserve. But it has a relationship because it's also an indication of what we have as compared to what we consume.
Who has the right to withdraw from the foreign reserve?
Well, I wouldn't go into that much because it's not within the purview of the commission's responsibility. The central bank should be able to educate you more on that. But of the excess crude account, usually what happens is when there's a shortfall in any month, either by production or sales, the Federation Account Allocation Committee considers if it's approved, they withdraw from that excess crude to make up the imbalance.
Are you suggesting that the RMAFC has the sole right to determine who gets what from the Federation accounts?
No. Far from it. What the revenue mobilization does only is to ensure that revenue generated goes to the Federation account. It monitors it from source to the destination, which is the Federation account in Central Bank, and also monitors the disbursement from there to the three tiers of government. And generally, we are misunderstood. Some even think that the revenue mobilization is an agency that share money. We don't share money. It's also, some people think it's an agency that can add or subtract. No, that sharing is done by Federation Account Allocation Committee, made up of all the commissioners of finance of the 36 states and the FCT, and then the Minister of Finance, who is the chairman, and then the agencies that contribute to the Federation account. So that is where such decisions are taken. So the commission doesn't share money directly. It monitors and mobilizes revenue for sharing.
So who has the final say to say this should go to this?
You know, in practice, the federal government, the state government, are beneficiaries of this account. you could have heard sometime they meet and agree that what has happened, that's on policy level. But general administration, when they meet, the committee of commissioners and the Minister of Finance, when they meet and see a shortfall, they agree that this amount should be brought to make up the shortfall, but not to withdraw at will. But if there is a situation that the government must assess that, it's usually done by the three tiers of the two, the federal and state government, agreeing that this is what should be done, because it's their money.
Then if this is so, why do we have so much tantrums between some governors who allege that $5 billion was missing from the Federation account? This isn't a small money. What do you think?
I think that is a mere allegation. It's yet to be proved. Because I would be surprised if such money is missing, because every month, all these commissioners from every state meet, and they are represented. And beyond that, there is another subcommittee called post-mortem subcommittee, which is made up of representatives of commissioners from the zones and the generating agencies, where they look through the contribution, the revenues from every generating agency. They go through it, and if there are areas of differences, it is sorted out. They look at it. So I'll be surprised that $5 billion is not small money that we just missed like that. So, well, the allegation should be substantiated.
Who should be held accountable for the inability of some governors to pay workers' salary? The government are pointing accusing fingers to the shortfall in the Federation account. But is this really tenable? Find out when we return.